When you first create a pivot table in Excel, it's probably going to be styled a little something like this one. This is likely not how you need for it to look. Let's talk about how to change the pivot table styles in Excel so that you can start making your pivot table reports look just how you want them. Whenever your active cell is anywhere inside the pivot table, you'll see this pivot table tools options menu come up, and it has two tabs, the analyze and the design tab. Your formatting options will be in the design tab. And here you'll have several pivot table styles to select from, and all are organized from lighter to darker based on the color palette selected. You can find your color palette under page layout in the theme section under colors, or like I have a shortcut to it here above my ribbon. So going back to the design, notice if I switch out my color palette, not just does my active pivot table change, but also the table styles available change. So if you have specific brand colors you need to use, you should create your own custom color palette. And then, like I have this one here, you can quickly access pivot table style options based on those colors. But let's go back to the office default. You can also create your own pivot table style. Simply go into the pivot table styles, go to where it says new pivot table style, and click on this. And here you'll see a list of all the pivot table style elements available, and you'll have formatting options for each. So for example, if I select the whole table, I can click on format, and let's say I want to make it green, click OK, and you'll see this in the preview window here. Now you won't be able to see all the elements in the preview screen, but you'll see most. For example, if you come to the report filter values and you decide you want to make those red and bold, you won't see those in the preview screen, but you will see a lot of these. Once you've made your formatting changes, if you're good with them, then you're set. Otherwise, you can click clear to clear those formatting changes. And once you're done, assign a name to your pivot table style, and you will likely want to check off that this will be the default for the current document and press OK to save it. Next, you can decide if you want to use banded rows and or banded columns, and whether or not you want to highlight your row or column header so that they stand out. The look of these is going to vary depending on the style you've selected, and let me move this over so I can show you. So right now we're using one of the lighter styles, but notice as we go into the medium and the dark options, the way that the banded rows, banded columns, and the headers are all highlighted is going to vary. So you simply select a look that you like and you're set. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.